Hi there, and welcome to Lucidate's fifth video on transformer neural networks. In recent years, transformers have become one of the most popular architectures in natural language processing and other areas of artificial intelligence. In this video, we'll be diving into what transformers like ChatGPT are, how they work, and why they're so powerful. In this video, we'll discuss the encoder-decoder architecture. We'll look at what the transformer does during training and inference. Training is what it does when it's learning by example and updating its weights. Inference is when it's running and predicting the next sequence of words. This will lead to a discussion of why we have something called masked attention and what the mask does. Transformers consist of two main components, the encoder and the decoder. The encoder takes in the input data and transforms it into a compact, low-dimensional representation called the hidden state. The decoder then takes this hidden state and produces the final output. For NLP tasks, such as ChatGPT, the inputs to the encoder are words. As discussed in prior videos, machine learning models don't process words. They only understand scalars, vectors, matrices, and tensors. So one way to think of the encoder is translating human-readable words into the hidden state tensor representation, which is understood and interpretable by the AI model. Likewise, the decoder does the reverse. It's responsible for translating the machine-readable hidden state into a human-readable sequence. As the name suggests, the transformer model will transform the sequence somehow. The output sequence might be a translation of the input sequence, let's say from French to German. It might be a summary of the input sequence, or it might be the generation of an entire article from a simple headline or first sentence. The first thing that the encoder does is to convert these words into vectors. To understand how this so-called semantic embedding works, please see the second video in this series. The next thing the encoder does is to add positional embeddings to these vectors to record the position of each word in the sequence. The third video in this series concerns positional embeddings. Then the attention block will dynamically weight the importance of different elements in the sequence, determine which elements are most related to one another, and identify the relevant information for the transformation task it's been set. It does all this in the attention block, and the fourth video in this series covers attention. A useful analogy for attention is the rules of grammar. Now, let's be clear here, attention is not grammar. Grammar provides rules and principles that determine the relationship between words in a sentence and the roles of different words, verb, noun, etc. It does this to help determine the meaning of the sentence. Analogously, attention provides some learned rules between embeddings to better understand and formulate input and output sequences. So, let's turn our attention to both training and inference. First, training. Training a transformer for NLP begins with converting a sequence of words into a numerical representation known as an embedding. As per previous videos, this captures the meaning and position of each word in the input sequence. This embedding is then passed through a series of layers in the transformer to produce the final output. There are many successful use cases for transformers. Several are shown on your screen. To illustrate the training process, we'll focus on number 7 in this list, sentence completion. So let's choose an appropriate sentence for completion. The sentence will be, an input sequence generates an output sequence. For this illustration, our input sequence will be the first part of the sentence, an input sequence generates. And our output sequence will be an output sequence. We'll write our input sequence as an input to our encoder and the output sequence, our target, above the decoder. Firstly, our encoder will take these words and, using the techniques described in prior videos, convert them into a numeric representation. Along the way, they'll pick up semantic encodings, positional embeddings, and attention scores from the various modules in the encoder. The encoder will output our hidden state tensor. This tensor will be fed into the decoder. The goal here is to convert this tensor into our target sequence, which begins with the word an. Early on in training a transformer, the weights in our AI will be randomly initialized, and consequently, we would expect a random predicted word to emerge from our decoder. In this case, the word is hedgerow. We can calculate the difference between our expected word an and our incorrectly predicted word hedgerow using cosine similarity in our embedding space. Please see the second video in this series for a refresher on this concept. After this forward pass through the transformer, we can use backpropagation to update the trainable parameters in the encoder and the decoder. This includes the weights and biases in our feed-forward neural networks, as well as the Q, K, and V matrices in our attention modules. In this schematic, I've represented single attention heads. In sophisticated models like BERT, GPT-3, and ChatGPT, there will be multiple attention heads run in parallel. You'll hear the term multi-headed attention used to describe this. So after this first prediction, let's take stock. We have an incorrectly predicted word, hedgerow, rather than an. And we've used this incorrect prediction to update our transformer weights a little. And now we have the next word to predict in our sequence. The next word we want to correctly predict is output. And our input sequence is one word longer. In order to train the network sensibly, we won't use the incorrectly predicted word hedgerow. Instead, we'll use the correct word an. This is called teacher forcing. This means that during training only, the model uses the true output sequence as an input for each time step instead of its own incorrect prediction. It means that at each step of the training process, the model is fed the actual ground truth output sequence instead of relying on the predicted output from the previous step. We then go again. Now the word we're trying to predict is output, and we now have a longer input sequence. We have the original input sequence of an input sequence generates concatenated with the next teacher forced word, an. These are fed into the encoder and decoder as shown. Once again, we take a forward pass through the transformer, generating the word embeddings, multiplying the embeddings by the attention matrices, and feeding our neural networks. And we generate our second produced word in the sequence. Once again, in the early stages of training, this is likely to be way off, and we'll use the error to update our weights, and we go again and again and again. During this training, we use a forward pass to generate an estimate. We compare the expected result with this estimate and backpropagate the error. We repeat this millions or billions of times to hammer the tunable parameters to where they need to be. If this seems like brute force, then it is. This is the unsubtle end of AI. While many of the solutions are very elegant, the reality of most AI systems is that you need a vast amount of training data, a huge computing surface of GPUs or TPUs, and months of training to get these models of this sophistication into shape. The mask in the attention head has a crucial role to play here. If the sequence's input into the transformer are less than the maximum length, then the mask will pad out the sequence with null values. More importantly, during training, it will stop the decoder from peeking ahead and looking at the next word in the sequence. A diagonal matrix in the mask ensures that the transformer can only pay attention to the input sequence from the hidden state and the number of words generated in the output sequence so far. Having looked at training, inference is much simpler. When we're training, we follow each forward pass with a backpropagation step to update the weights in the transformer. With inference, we just have forward passes to get the next word. There's no teacher forcing during inference. We simply append the word we've predicted to our input sequence and run another forward pass to generate another predicted word. This continues until we encounter a stop sequence, that is to say, a code that stops the transformer generating further input. In summary, we've explored the concept of transformer neural networks and their significance in natural language processing and artificial intelligence. We looked at the encoder-decoder architecture. The encoder converts the input data into a low-dimensional representation called the hidden state, while the decoder produces the final human-readable output. We saw how the transformer converts words into a numeric representation utilizing positional embeddings. And we checked out the attention mechanism that dynamically weights the relationships and relevance of elements in the sequence. We also looked at the brute force training process, utilizing backpropagation to update the parameters in the transformer, using huge training datasets over millions or billions of iterations. Finally, we used an example of sentence completion to illustrate the steps involved during inference in transforming a sequence of words into a target output sequence. Now, this is a lot to take in. As ever, do rewind and review points that I may have glossed over too quickly. Please do review the other videos in this playlist covering semantics, positional embeddings, and attention. And do leave questions and suggestions in the comments section. I will try to reply to all that I can. If you've liked this video, then by all means hit the like button. And if you'd like to be notified of more videos on AI, capital markets, and DeFi from Lucidate, then please do hit the subscribe button. This is Richard Walker from Lucidate. Thanks for watching. Please join me in the next video when we see how easy it is to customize transformer models like GPT-3. In the next video, we will look at foundation models and fine tuning. Thank you.